Hello students, I am Nisha Desai. In last session we talk about why Britishers came to India, how they rooted themselves in India, how Vasco da Gama reached India and how he discovered new sea route to India. In previous standard we have learned in ancient time our country was one of the leading countries in the world. Many people from various countries were influenced by our culture and prosperity. They wanted to enter in trade with our country. Now we are going to learn arrival of Europeans to India, arrival of British and establishment of trade centers. The Portuguese were the first to arrive in India for trade after the discovery of the sea route to India. Within a span of 100 years, the Portuguese took control of several territories like Diu, Daman, Goa, Cochin and Malacca. Inspired by the Portuguese success in trade, the Dutch and the Danish were arrived in India for trade. The English Trade Center established the East India Company for carry out trade with India. As we know, Vasco da Gama discovered new sea route to India and Vasco da Gama was Portuguese. So the Portuguese were first who arrived in India for trade. In the time of 100 years, the Portuguese were took control of several territories like Diu, Daman, Goa, Malacca, Cochin. And by the inspiration of Portuguese, many other people like Dutch and Danish were also arrived in India for the trade. In 1600 AD, Queen Elizabeth of England gave the permission to the East India Company to carry out trade with the eastern countries. So, the first ship under the leadership of Captain William Hawkins arrived in Surat. But due to the dominance and opposition from the Portuguese, they were not allowed to establish their trade there. But finally, the East India Company got permission from the Mughal Emperor Jahangir. The British East India Company established its first trade center in Surat in 1613 AD. After the getting permission from Queen Elizabeth, the East India Company carried out the trade with eastern countries. So the first ship under the leadership of Captain William Hawkins arrived to Surat. But at that time, Portuguese were there because of Portuguese dominance and oppositions, they were not allowed to establish their trade in Surat. East India Company got permission from Mughal Emperor Jahangir. Then after they established their first trade center in Surat in 1613 AD. This question can be asked for 1 mark. Where and when did the British East India Company established its first trade center? Initially, the company established its trade centers in Surat, Bharuch, Ahmedabad due to the strong presence of Marathas in this region. The company sensed danger to its existence. They moved towards to south and east directions, where they set up their centers in Machilipatnam, St. George and Fort William. Mumbai became their headquarter in 1687 AD. The French East India Company arrived in India for trade in 1688 AD. Company established its centers in Surat, Bharuch and Ahmedabad. But because of Marathas, they found themselves in danger. So they moved towards to the south and east directions and they set up their centers in Machilipatnam, St. George and William Fort. But Mumbai became their headquarter in 1687 AD. Then after, the French East India Company arrived in India for trade in 1668 AD. This question also can be asked for 1 mark. When did the French East India Company arrive in India for trade? They eventually set up their trade centers in Mahe, Pondicherry, Chandranagar and Machilipatnam. In the 18th century, The English and the French were constantly busy establishing their rule in the entire world and conquering more territories. Between 1746 and 1763, there were three Karnataka wars between the French East India Company and the British East India Company in India, which the French East India Company lost. The expansion of the British East India Company became easy. Company set up their trade centers in different cities, in different places like Mahe, Pondicherry, Chandranagar and Machilipatnam. And in 18th century, East India Company and French, British East India Company and French East India Company become rival and they started conquering themselves in the world. Between 1746 and 1763, there were three wars, in Karnataka wars, between French East India Company and British East India Company, in which French East India Company lost the war. After the loss of this war, the expansion of the British East India Company became very easy. At the end of this battle for power, the Portuguese were left Diu, Daman and Goa. French had their trade centers at Chandranagar, Mahe, Kalaikal and Pondicherry. The Dutch had to leave forever.
Remaining chapter we will discuss in the next session. Thank you.